Capricorn, hi. Welcome to your love reading. This is for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. It is a general reading. This may or may not resonate with every Capricorn watching this video. Okay, Capricorn, the overall energy we have for you is the Page of Swords here, right? So there is someone here who's watching you, stalking you from a distance, okay? This person is gathering a lot of information about you, doing a lot of research and trying to come towards you at the right time, okay? But definitely someone who's keeping an eye on you on your social media. In the past, with the Emperor in reverse here, I feel you could have released a person who was a control freak. Someone who always wanted things their way. It's like my way or the highway kinds. But someone very, very stubborn, okay? Someone who you're just not in alignment with. Or at the same time, this is someone, you know, who was just not taking control of the situation, okay? A very haphazard kind of a relationship that you had with this person, okay? But you were fed up and you gave up on this person. Right now with the Temperance here, I feel you're healing, okay? Temperance is the card of something that happens in divine timing, okay? So I feel there's something that's going on behind the scenes, okay? But there's a lot of healing. There is a reconciliation probably that's coming into the scenes, okay? And this is a very, very slow process, okay? So something's going to take a lot of time. If you're in a hurry, it's not going to work. If the person you're dealing with is in a hurry, it's not going to work, okay? So it's going to take their own time. And in the near future, we have the Moon here. This is about someone having a lot of feelings, but trying to suppress these feelings, okay? Someone has a lot of love here, but they're trying their best not to show it, okay? Deception, but the deception is around their feelings, okay? Someone who feels a lot, but they won't say it. Let's see. King of Wands in reverse, okay? So there's someone here who you're dealing with who's not taking action towards you, okay? Now this could be you, how you see yourself, okay? With the King of Wands in reverse here, you're being very laid back right now. You want to take action towards this person, okay? Or this person wants to take action towards you, but someone's just holding back. Because in your emotions with the King of Swords here, see, you're being very logical. You want to take action towards this person, okay? Like you wouldn't like do it like today, but you're just holding back. You're being very passive in your approach because you're trying to be very logical this time. You just don't want to jump in impulsively into something that you just want very badly, okay? With the Devil here, what's coming in your environment that you don't see coming is something very toxic, okay? But with the Devil here, this is also the card of lovers, but the lovers with the dark side to it, okay? So you're going to be very tempted to entertain this person who's coming in towards you. But with the Devil here, they're still bringing in that toxicity, someone who's very obsessed with you. However, in the outcome, we have the Four of Swords here. So there is going to be, I don't know if the communication is still going to start between you guys, but the Four of Swords is also withdrawal, retreating, right? Someone who's choosing to keep their mouth shut and think about a situation, but not take action. We'll see. What's the Page of Swords? What's the Page of Swords? Okay. Someone who you ended things with, okay? This is a situation that was just not getting to that point of commitment, okay? This person, you wanted commitment from them, they wanted it with you, but it was just not working out. You ended things with this person, okay? It could be as good as a long-term commitment, but it did end, okay? You let this person go, all right? And you no longer want to make this person a priority already in your life. You stress a lot about them, but this person refuses to let you go. All right, death in reverse here. They won't take action, but they won't even let you go at the same time. Yeah. So I think this person's stressing the shit out. Okay, this person wants recovery. Okay, they don't want to get into negative thoughts, but this person has a lot of self-doubt. Okay, a very lot of negative self-talk that they're doing. Okay, about this relationship here. That's why they're just watching you. Okay, because they feel that things will not work out between you guys after this ending, okay? You've let them go, but they haven't, all right? This is someone you're dealing with who is non-committal, someone who wasn't taking the lead in the relationship. See, that's why the Emperor in reverse. Tell me about the Emperor in reverse in the past. Let's clarify this. What's the Emperor in reverse? Yeah. Clearly there was a lot of disappointment in the past, okay, that had to deal with this person out here. This is someone here who probably, someone came off to be as very, very clingy and needy, or this was someone here where, you know, this person refused to take a risk with you. they look at you as someone, you know, who was a big risk or someone who they didn't trust, okay? They were ready to, someone was ready to be in a relationship, okay? Someone probably even wanted commitment, okay? But because there was a lot of crying over spilled milk, okay? Or something just didn't land up the way you wanted to. I feel this person has a lot to do with their past because of which is influencing them in their current situation with you, okay? Which is messing up the potential of this relationship. This person has trust issues. Okay, and all that has to do with the Five of Cups here. They're constantly crying over spilled milk about the past, something that didn't work out in the past. Yes, this person was ready to be with you. Okay, they probably gave up their singlehood, you know. But you were definitely dealing with someone who does not want to be in a commitment. Okay, someone who is very fearful of losing their independence, you know. But because they were crying over spilled milk, they had no structure. Okay, and they were just very rigid about their belief systems. Okay. Commitment being one of them, non-committal, someone who wanted something very non-traditional, okay? What's the temperance here in the current situation? Beautiful. Two of Pentacles, the Four of Wands, and the King of Swords in reverse. There is a situation here where someone's trying to work on commitment, someone's trying to work on something long-term with you, okay? This is the same person who's trying to watch you from a distance, okay? This person's thinking, okay? They're going back and forth with a decision. They haven't made up their mind about wanting to commit to you, okay? But they're not telling you, they're not talking to you about it, okay? King of Swords in reverse. This is someone who's not clearly communicating or someone who's suppressing the truth from coming out in the open. This person's just going to be super slow, okay? So don't expect them to come towards you very fast, okay? It's going to be very, very slow moving, and they're taking their time, okay? Because Two of Pentacles, they're constantly weighing the pros and cons about what, you know, trying to weigh out their options. Or this is someone here who's trying to work out a way of how they can come towards you, because I don't see you as someone who's wanting to keep you as an option. Otherwise we wouldn't have had the Four of Wands. I feel this is someone here who you cut out in the past, okay? Someone who's very cold, detached, or this is how they're being towards you. They're thinking of commitment with you, but Two of Pentacles here, they're taking their own time, okay? They're wanting to make the right approach towards you, and that's what they're thinking about, okay? Eight of Cups, someone who you walked away from, all right? But they're not letting you go, like I said. I can't stress enough. What's the moon here in the near future? Again, the same shit. Oh, we have four cards. All right. We have the Tower in reverse, the Page of Swords in reverse, the Six of Wands in reverse, and the Five of Swords here. Someone's constantly sabotaging the connection here to avoid a disaster. There's one person here who's constantly watching, spying, looking, the same shit in the near future. So I feel they're still not making a decision, and it is going to continue in the near future. Okay? They're still holding on. They're waiting. I think this person does not feel confident enough. They probably feel that either they will come in and things will like completely screw up. You'll probably just, you know, like blow the lid, okay? You'll just shoo them away. You're going to shut the case once and for all. They're lacking the confidence because something didn't work out in the past, right? So what's happening here with the Five of Cups here? This person tends to hold on to the past, okay? They have a tendency of constantly grieving over what didn't work out, what didn't work out, what didn't work out, okay? So it's a very low vibrational energy. And when you stay in that energy, right, for too long, you tend to get into depression, which leads to a lot of inaction. And that's exactly what's happening. They're constantly focused and investing their energies into what is gone, which no longer exists, okay? Instead of focusing on the present, what they can work out, they're like, oh, you know what? It's not going to work out. They keep talking themselves down, you know? They want marriage. They want commitment, you know? But again, they're like, what if it doesn't work out? What if Capricorn rejects me, you know? They constantly think about what can go wrong in this relationship if they pursue it rather than thinking of the possibilities, you know, taking leaps of doubt. Yeah, see, there's again that same sabotage, holding on to their emotions. They're not going to talk in the near future too because they're trying to avoid a disaster. This person's heavily, they're very afraid to approach you, you know, Capricorn. They're very scared to approach you. What's the King of Wands in reverse? Why is the King of Wands in reverse here? Clarify the King of... Hold on, clarify the King of Wands in reverse. One more card. The King of Wands in reverse. shit, it keeps coming up over and over again in the overall energy. It's showing up in the reading also. You're dealing with someone who wants to take action, but they won't do it. They won't do it. They're determined to not take action. They're being very passive. They won't take the lead role. And the King of Wands in reverse, to me, is someone who's just not confident about the actions that they want to take, you know? That there's someone, you know, who's, I wouldn't say who's playing games, because that's not what I see here, but this is someone who's very nervous, you know, very nervous, they're scared, they're very intimidated by you. Again, I just can catch the same thing, they're scared, you're going to reject them, you're just going to blow them off, you know? They're not confident about this decision, you know? That's why they're not taking the lead. Anyways, the King of Wands in reverse here, the High Priestess in reverse, Knight of Swords and the Nine of Wands here. You're dealing with someone here who wants to talk to you, okay? Who wants to talk to you like now. Like they would want to speak to you. Like this is, the Knight of Swords is someone who's wanting to talk, who's in a hurry, right? You know, who's very aggressive, but someone who wants to prove a point, okay? But the problem here is they're on guard. This is someone, you know, who you've dealt with over and over again, okay? This is definitely, this could be you, because this is how you see yourself, okay? I think there's someone here who's coming towards you, okay? Probably someone who's coming towards you, breaking the silence, okay? You're finally ready to talk, you know, revealing their feelings. But with the Nine of Wands, I feel you're very guarded. You've tried to make things work out with this person over and over and over again. But this time, I think in your emotions with the King of Swords, you're being very logical about this. It could also mean with the High Priestess in reverse here, I'm getting... You are someone who's very intuitive, but this time your intuition is blocked. Your intuition is telling you something, but you're interpreting your intuition in the wrong way, you know. There's like this issue where you're not being able to differentiate between your ego and your intuition, okay? You're really pissed off with this person, agreed. But in your emotions with the King of Swords, this time you're planning to do it very, very logically, okay? No emotions, completely detached, you know? Because again, Nine of Wands, you're holding on to this, you're not giving up, okay? But that defense system, okay? You're so guarded from this person, like you come back around with the same shit, that's it, you know? So yeah, there is communication, or you're probably, you even feel the need, but it's just that for you, you're just doing your best to hold back from this person. Who's the devil here? Why is the devil here? This is someone you don't see coming in your environment. This is what you don't see coming. Clap at the devil. Clap at the devil. There is someone in your environment that's very, very toxic, okay? This is someone who needs to make a decision, but they're keeping you on an edge, okay? They're sitting on the fence doing nothing about it. Yeah, the same person I'm talking about. Someone non-committal, someone who's very, could be financially someone unstable, okay? So they're very sure about what they want, okay? This person could be very confused in the past. They could have kept their options open. Even if they didn't have options, they just kept an open mind, okay, when it came to you. They were not zoned into you, okay? This time, they're very clear about what they want, and they know they need to make a choice here, but they're still not making it. They're keeping you waiting. Someone non-committal again. King of Pentacles in reverse. Someone who's not stable. Someone who's probably more, very materialistic, okay? If not materialistic, someone who's more focused on their money, business, career goals, okay? Relationship is not a priority for them, and that's the kind of person who's in your environment, okay? That's why, see, that's why you feel the need to be very logical with this person, because you're like, you know what, I'm done involving my emotions, I get hurt every time, and I'm fed up. What's the King of Swords here? What's the King of Swords? Why is the King of Swords here in your emotions, Capricorn? Jellybean, you're not putting in your work anymore. King of Swords, Queen of Swords here. See? You've given this person an ultimatum. I feel, okay, or you just have a lot of questions if this person comes in. This person is your soulmate, okay? But I think you want to move towards this person, okay? You want to. But it's your logic that's holding you back. You know, you have a strong soulmate connection to this person, a soul tie. There is, you know, something, there's like this huge energetic difference, okay, that you have. Not energetic, what am I saying? Yeah, there is a very big difference between you guys. Could be age, could be place, something, okay? But there's could be an age difference most of the times here, okay? But something very, very different about you guys, significantly different, okay? You're wanting to move towards this person because you have this strong urge, okay? You have the strong realization, this is the what for you. But with the Queen of Swords here and the King of Swords here, right? You can't help but to be very, very... You're being very fact-based right now, okay? Like, just logic. And you're just forced to think about this entire situation keeping your emotions on the side. Okay, you're not putting in any work for now. Okay, you're just done putting in the work. I think you want this person to make a move towards you, and if they do also, you want them to come towards you with the truth and the reality, and that's all you got for them, okay? Whilst this person here, see, this is the kind of energy that you're emitting, right? The Queen of Swords, you know, the King of Swords, stuff like that. And this person is coming off as the Knight of Swords, the Page of Swords, okay? So this person is heavily intimidated by you, Capricorn, okay? Maybe you'd want to just get into a more... you know, you don't need to take such a drastic approach towards this person, okay, energetically. Maybe you should soften your stance. I don't know what they did to you. This is a general reading, so I don't know your story, but that's what the reading says. They're too intimidated. They want a commitment with you. They want this with you, but they're just not making a move towards you, okay? And because they're not making a move towards you is because they're afraid. They're very fearful of what's going to happen, you know, which is why they sabotage this, okay? So, yeah. Again, watching, spying, looking, not doing anything about it, you know, not really directly communicating with you because they're just scared. What's the Four of Swords here? See, that's what the outcome is. There's still no movement. What's the Four of Swords here? The Lovers, the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, and the Seven of Wands here. Someone needs to make a choice. There's one person here who's just not putting in the work, okay? Someone feels the need to guard themselves, okay? To stand up for themselves, to protect themselves. But the Seven of Wands to me is the energy of, well, like, do you really have a threat that you have to be so guarded, you know? Seven of Wands is standing up for yourself, right? But this is also someone who's creating boundaries, okay? But there is this silent treatment that's still the outcome here. There's just no movement here because this is someone who's still not moving towards you. You're dealing with someone, Capricorn. Okay, that's you. Knight of Pentacles in reverse here. You could be this one, or this could be the person you're dealing with. Someone's very slow moving, okay? And this is someone who's stringing the connection along, okay? You feel you're being strung along in the connection. They're doing nothing. The Lovers here. So there is the strong soul. The Lovers, the Six of Cups, dude. I cannot... put even more emphasis on how strong this connection is, okay? Which is why this person refuses to let you go, which is why they don't want to end this. But they're not putting in the work, okay? Because Seven of Wands here, this person's too defensive. They feel the need to, you know, stand up for themselves. But it's like with the Seven of Wands here, I feel this person's too defensive. Defensive in a way, you know, where they're scared. They're afraid. It's almost like, either this person is blocking you, okay, or they've still blocked communication. It's more like a defensive mechanism, okay? They have their guards up due to the past hurt, okay? So yeah, this could, when the Seven of Wands comes in, to me sometimes it's also like we're sometimes blocking something good that's coming your way. And that's what they're doing. They're coming in their own way here. They're not putting in the work and effort right now, okay? Things are just, this could be someone who's very focused on their inner goals, okay? Like working on themselves, you know, rather than wanting to work on the present situation or trying to work the situation out. Again, they realize the soulmate connection, they realize this twin flame connection, but they're just blocking because, I don't know. The Justice here, see? There's this energy of wanting to make things right. They want to work on this connection. They want to rectify the situation. They want to release themselves from this situation, okay? Not release, but this is someone who's getting out of their head and wanting to come towards you to give you that balanced relationship, okay? To make things fair. But till their guards are up, okay? This is someone who's coming in their own way and you can't really do much about it, okay? The only thing you can do is energetically either forgive this person and move on, or then just try to heal and try to soften your stance so that energetically they can feel open to coming towards you. Maybe you have this person blocked, you know? But yeah, I don't see this person making a move towards you in the near future or in the outcome. It's gonna take some time, all right? I'm just gonna tell you how it is. But they are thinking about marriage, they are thinking about long-term, they are thinking about commitment, okay? They're not gonna let you go. So that's what I have for you, all right? If this resonates, do leave your comments below. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye. And I will see you.